Hi there, this is Gilbert Escamilla, your host from Curious Journey Reacts, and today we're going to take a look at the Isla de las Muñecas in Xochimilco. Rather sinister looking thing. Let's go. Wow. Rather creepy, I would say.
¿Qué tal amigos de México Desconocido? Yo soy Stephanie Cisneros y el día de hoy nos encontramos en uno de los lugares más emblemáticos de la Ciudad de México. Como pueden ver, es Xochimilco y en este momento estamos en uno de los canales directo a la Isla de las Muñecas.
Okay, so Stephanie here is going to be our guide from México Desconocido or Unknown Mexico. And she's going to be our guide basically for the Isla de las Muñecas. And she's going to tell us a little bit about the story. So let's see what's going to go on.
Lugar de leyendas y misterio.
A place of legend and mystery. Yeah, it's a mystery why anybody would want to do that, but let's see. The Island of the Dolls, Xochimilco.
Entre los canales de Xochimilco hay una chinampa distinta a las otras. Es un lugar aterrador y misterioso. La gente le llama la Isla de las Muñecas.
Okay, so Xochimilco is more of a visitor type place. It's a lake that used to be the canals where the Aztecs used to have their irrigation for their crops way back in the time before the conquistadors came. And apparently this place stands out away from the rest, as you can see, and we're gonna see why.
Su fundador fue Don Julián, un hombre solitario cuya tranquilidad fue robada cuando encontró algo espantoso, el cadáver de una joven que había muerto ahogada.
Okay, so Don Julián was the owner of the property of that particular island, and apparently one day he found the cadaver of a young girl that had drowned. So let's see.
Desde ese momento, el espectro de la difunta no lo dejaba tranquilo, así que, para protegerse, Don Julián comenzó a recolectar muñecas de los canales y de la basura.
Okay, so apparently, the spirit from the young girl would not let him go. He would have nightmares. And to try and alleviate a little bit of that, he started collecting dolls. He would buy some himself and he'd collect them from people that would throw them away on the trash, and he started decorating the whole place with these dolls. Apparently, there was a reason to his madness for the poor guy.
Luego las ponía en los árboles y alambres de su chinampa. Las muñecas, con las lluvias y el tiempo, se volvieron siniestras.
He would hang them all along his property with some wire on the trees, and then over a period of time, the weather would take its effect and give them a very sinister look.
Así, según contaba Don Julián, la horrible apariencia de los juguetes ahuyentaría el ánima de la joven y de los demás espíritus malignos que rondaban los canales.
He believes that the appearance of the dolls, the sinister look of the dolls, would be enough to keep away the evil spirits, not only from the girl that he found in the river, but any other evil spirits that surrounded the property. It definitely would scare me away.
Fue así como nació lo que después sería una aterradora tradición. El lugar poco a poco cobró fama. Los vecinos y turistas comenzaron a llevar sus muñecas viejas. Pronto, la chinampa llegó a tener más de 1,500 de aquellos juguetes.
Wow. Apparently, this turned into a tradition. A very curious tradition, I would say. As not only him, but visitors, friends of his, visitors to the lake, to the Xochimilco, will bring their own dolls. And over time, it is estimated that there are over 1,500 dolls decorating the island. Wow.
Sin embargo, el 17 de abril de 2001, don Julián murió. Su cuerpo fue hallado en el mismo lugar donde, años atrás, había encontrado aquel cadáver que originó todo.
Oh, wow. Okay. In 2001, Don Julian, the man who found the body of the young girl, he died. And supposedly his body was found in the same place where he found the cadaver of the young girl that many years earlier. Now that is creepy.
A pesar de la terrible pérdida, la tradición no terminó. Esta fue continuada por Anastasio Santana, el sobrino de Don Julián, quien se encargó de mantener viva la leyenda hasta que, el 13 de febrero del 2019, también falleció.
So, apparently, the tradition did not end with Don Julián. His nephew took over the tradition, and he continued on until he died in 2019. Oh, whoa, wait a minute, hold on. Did those eyes move? Okay, we gotta take a look at that. Okay, that could have been somebody jostling the head of the doll, but that was pretty freaky. Let's check it out.
13 de febrero de 2019. También falleció.
Oh, man.
Hoy en día son los familiares de aquellos valientes hombres quienes se encargan de que la Isla de las Muñecas continúe vigente. Actualmente hay más de 2.500 muñecas y la colección sigue creciendo, pues
wow.
La gente las lleva como ofrenda a Don Julián y a Agustinita.
Okay, so apparently the relatives and friends of both men continue the tradition. And now it is estimated that there are about 2,500 dolls all along the island. It's a tradition that will never die, apparently.
El juguete favorito de Don Julián y el único al que le puso nombre.
Wait a minute, hold on, let's go back to that for a second, sorry guys. So there's something special about this particular doll right here. And I didn't catch it, so let's take a look at it again, okay?
Sigue creciendo, pues. La gente las lleva como ofrenda a Don Julián y a Agustinita, el juguete favorito de Don Julián y el único al que le puso nombre.
Okay. Apparently, this particular doll is the only one that Don Julián gave a name to. And I'm trying to see what her name was. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put the little closed caption and see if... Agustinita. Okay, Lil Agustina, I guess you could say, as a close translation into English. Agustinita, Lil Agustina.
A Don Julián y a Agustinita.
Agustinita right there.
De Don Julián y el único al que le puso nombre.
It's the only doll that he gave a name
to. Agustinita fue hallada un 28 de agosto, día de San Agustín. Quizá por ello se dice que es capaz de cumplir los deseos de todo aquel que se lo pida. ¿Y tú? ¿Te atreverías a visitar esta siniestra isla?
Would you dare go to the Isla de las Muñecas? That's what she's
saying.
Pues
bueno, amigos, esperamos que les haya gustado este recorrido, que los anime a venir para acá a conocer las leyendas que tiene Xochimilco para ustedes y que vivan esta experiencia. Cuéntenos en los comentarios qué les pareció, si vendrían, si se animarían a pasar la noche aquí y qué les pareció. Nos vemos.
Basically, she's giving us a cordial invitation to come over and visit the beauty of Xochimilco and maybe dare to take a visit to the Isla de las Muñecas. I might do that if I ever go to Mexico City, but I don't know. Definitely not at night, that's for sure. And there you have it. If you liked the video, please subscribe, like, leave a comment. Let me know if you dare spend the night in the Isla de las Muñecas. Incidentally, there is a place up in Llano, Texas that is along the same veins. It involves the heads of dolls instead, though. I might take a trip out there and see what that's all about. But until then, hey, thanks for watching. See you later.